Hey everyone, welcome to this session on machine learning in 15. Today we're going to be talking about Amazon SageMaker high performance inference at low cost. I'm Raghu Ramesha, senior machine learning architect in the SageMaker service team. Let's quickly take a look at our agenda for the day. We'll cover three topics today. We'll start off with understanding what is SageMaker, why our customers choose SageMaker for machine learning inference over DIY. Then we'll introduce different components of machine learning model deployment options on SageMaker, followed up with techniques to optimize and attain high performance at low cost. Finally, we'll summarize with best practices. Amazon SageMaker is a managed service that accelerates every stage of your machine learning lifecycle, from providing managed end-user experiences such as Jupyter notebooks and low-code, no-code machine learning tools, libraries for easily training and deploying models, along with model monitoring capabilities. SageMaker provides everything that data scientists and machine learning teams need in order to be successful with their projects. There are literally hundreds of big things that SageMaker does for you. Then DIY would have to spend time and resources to build it yourself. First is just how much infrastructure SageMaker helps you set up and manage, from instance to the container optimized with machine learning libraries and frameworks, to the storage, to networking and load balancing, to the encryption layer. All of this is handled for you. If you are using a feature like multi-model endpoints, which we'll touch upon later, SageMaker Inference sets up smart routing to route your requests for specific models when they are cached in a SageMaker environment quickly and without having to worry about anything. On an ongoing basis, SageMaker is measuring traffic that's coming to your endpoint and can automatically scale the compute resources that you need to serve your elastic changes in your traffic. You don't have to worry about any hardware failing with SageMaker because the service is built at a highly available and redundant by default. Even across availability zones, you have two or more instances running. Data scientists frequently want to test new models in production. You can do that through deployment strategies such as shadow deployments, shadow testing, A/B testing, canary, and linear deployments. SageMaker provides deployment strategies which can act as guardrails so that you can easily move between different models in production. SageMaker model deployment provides a wide selection of hardware and features to meet your requirements for your machine learning workload. If you're not sure which one to use for your workload, we also have fully managed service that can help you with recommendations that are tailored to your workload. In addition to hardware, we also have different deployment options. So let's unpack the different modes that are available in SageMaker for deployment. The first is real-time inference that we spoke about. In this, your client application sends data to your model via HTTP request. The endpoint will route the request to your appropriate instance, run it through your model, and then return a result. This is ideal both for real-time applications that require ultra-low latencies and high throughput. Examples of this could be like ad serving, personalization, recommendations, etc. Related to your first is serverless inference. Serverless inference is not using an instance-based compute environment. It's using a compute environment that gets activated upon a request coming in. This is ideal for workloads that have unpredictable or intermittent traffic. When you're expecting traffic in certain amount of time in a certain duration. Examples of this can be doc processing, chatbots, etc. The primary benefit of using serverless inference is that it helps drastically reduce your cost. For highly intermittent use cases, you can reduce your cost by 90% to even compared to your real-time inferences. You could also back it by using provisioned concurrency, which helps you define, which helps you bring in predefined amount of instances that will be ready to be ready when your requests come in and are warm to respond immediately. The third is your async inference. Async inference packs a lot under the hood. It works in a queue architecture. This means that instead of making a request and getting the model response in real time, you can place an inference request onto a queue. Then you'll get a notification in real time that your request has been processed. SageMaker will automatically scale all of this compute instances and models to handle the size and performance of your use case. This is really nice architecture for use cases that require longer compute time to be processed, or when you want to scale down the instances to zero. This is one of the use cases where this is very useful is your computer vision or NLP use cases. Lastly, we have batch transform. These are use cases or offline use cases when you don't want responses in real time. Use cases such as nightly customer scoring, or propensity models, churn prediction and analysis, you can place your inputs into an S3 bucket, have this processing job run for you, and dump the results back into an S3 bucket. So you can see there are multiple different options here, each of which we have different performance and consideration that can help you optimize in your environment. SageMaker is purpose-built to support ultra-low latencies of under 5 milliseconds for small payloads. It provides optimized ML framework, containers, compute instances, storage, and network. Additionally, has built-in data for security for data encryption at rest and at transit. SageMaker also provides supports 10 million plus transactions per second. It has built-in routing layers to distribute and prevent overloading. It has built-in logging and metering support as well. SageMaker offers about 99.95% of availability SLA. It continues to run routine health checks and replace unhealthy instances automatically. Finally, SageMaker also offers cost-effective techniques that can help you and your business scale, such as multi-model endpoints, serverless inference, instance right-sizing, and model compilation tools. This is a pricing model that allows you to save up to 64% of Amazon SageMaker instances in exchange of making a small commitment to a consistent amount of usage for a 1 or 3 year term. SageMaker savings plan automatically applies to your eligible ML instances usage, regardless of the instance family size or AWS region. With SageMaker savings plan, eligible ML instances usage can usage up to the commitment will be charged at the savings plan rate. Any usage will beyond that will be on demand rates. Finally, we'll look at what powers your SageMaker endpoints. So for finding the right compute instance, we have a capability called Inference Recommender. SageMaker Inference Recommender tool allows SageMaker customers to perform automated load testing and find model tuning across ML instances. You can use Inference Recommender to deploy your models to a real-time endpoint with best performance at lowest cost. Inference Recommender helps you select the best instance and the configurations, such as your instance count, the container parameters, and environment variables and model optimizations. With SageMaker Inference Recommender, you have two options. One, you could use a default job to make some preliminary recommendations. And if you have an advanced use case where you want to run a custom load test, you could use the advanced job to run custom load tests and get granular control over your performance tuning. And the best aspect of using SageMaker Inference Recommender is it only charges you for the instances that are used during your job. So let's look at some strategies and best practices for optimizing costs on SageMaker. SageMaker provides scalable and cost-effective ways to deploy large number of ML models. With SageMaker multi-model endpoints, you can deploy thousands of models behind a single endpoint, improving your cost-effectiveness while providing the flexibility to use models as and when you need them. It works best when you have models of similar size and latencies and belong to the same ML framework. You can dynamically load the respective models onto SageMaker endpoint to serve your requests. The second strategy is by combination of using low-cost instances and your compiled models. And you can use tools such as SageMaker Neo here. SageMaker Neo enables developers to optimize machine learning models for inference on cloud instances to run faster with zero to loss in accuracy. And by comparing different instance types, again, remember that we spoke about inference recommender before, that can help you right size. And you can run custom load tests here to identify and execute the same patterns that you expect in your production traffic, benchmark and choose the right instances. By using a combination of these compiled models and using the right set of instances, you can lower your costs. The third strategy is by using either SageMaker async inference or using serverless inferences as and when it's possible. With SageMaker async inference and serverless inference, you can scale down the instances to zero when you're not using the endpoint. Using SageMaker async inference for requests with large payloads and large processing time, and it has near real-time latency requirements. Whenever you do not have any traffic coming in, you can set up auto-scaling policies to bring down the instances count to zero and thereby save costs. With serverless inference, these are ideal for workloads when you have idle periods between traffic. So you can scale up those instances when you need it and then bring them down when you do not need them. The next strategy is by using multi-container endpoints. With multi-container endpoints, you can deploy up to 15 containers with diverse ML frameworks and functionalities with no cold starts and save costs on a single endpoint, SageMaker endpoint. You can directly invoke these containers, and it's best used when you want to keep all these models in memory. Additionally, you can use serial inference pipelines to chain up to 2 to 15 different containers onto a single SageMaker endpoint. And this is mostly suitable when you want to combine your pre-processing, model inference, and your post-processing within a single endpoint. And since all these containers are hosted on the same instance, you'll typically see lower latency operations. Let's summarize the best practice that we looked at for optimizing costs for SageMaker. Here, we looked at selecting the right instance type. It could be a CPU, GPU, or AWS inference here. And you could use the right inference option that works best for your use case. And next, you can maximize your instance utilization with throughput and latency considerations. You could use a SageMaker inference recommender for selecting the right instances. A best practice is to delete endpoints when they're not in use, especially for real-time endpoints. You could choose the right automated scaling policy based on your traffic pattern. For example, if you have workloads coming in at 9 a.m. and drying up at 5 p.m., you could use a scheduled scaling policy. Or if you want to use target tracking, for example, when you see a larger threshold in terms of your GPU utilization or CPU utilization, you could use one of those. Another best practice is to load test your endpoint and see what instance works best and what auto scaling works best here. Whenever possible, use serverless inference, multi-model endpoints, multi-container endpoints, async inferences as your application deem fit. Use caching features to reduce your latency. Leverage dynamic batching, which is basically batching combines individual inference requests together to improve your throughput. Also, you could use model optimization tools such as SageMaker Neo. And finally, we spoke about SageMaker Savings Plan. Thank you.